I love robots. But with every new technology on the market, patience is key to not be disappointed by an immature product. If robot vacuums are very expensive and impractical a few years ago, today they are a must-have in any household. Robot mowers make no exception to that rule. In fact, I believe that today we are closer than ever to the golden age of smart mowing, especially with the robot we're reviewing today,
the Luba 2 from Mowing. It's the 5000 edition.
The difference with the other models basically lies within the square meter mowing capacity. This one can mow up to 5000 square meter. Here is some context. We have a few rentals for the summer and we offer a nice little pool for our guests to relax. The problem is, our country law states that we need to protect the access to the pool with a special type of gate, making it hard for a traditional tractor to come in and do its job, especially with all the small obstacles that are easily damageable. This is where a smart robot mower can be super useful. In order to have the perfect lawn for our guests, we need to create a mowing plan that synchronizes with our sprinkler system, all of that while not bothering our guests. I'm going to walk you through the installation, setup process, and review while making a focus on connectivity, ease of use, and smart home integration. The Luba 2 doesn't need wires to locate itself. It uses an onboard GPS module and an RTK antenna. Both the robot and the RTK antenna communicate to a group of satellites in order to precisely locate the robot. The Luba being the moving object, the RTK antenna serves as a fixed reference point that helps the robot communicate its accurate position with centimeter precision. The RTK antenna communicates that information to the robot via a radio frequency technology called LoRa. The installation process is very simple. Plug and screw the Luba's vision module. This allows the robot to detect obstacles and offer a nice FPV view directly from within the app. Then place the front bumper for additional obstacle detection. Finally, insert one of the security key in the back of the robot, which prevents the robot from working if you don't have it inserted. The RTK antenna can easily be placed in the robot's base. But if you have a big terrain to mow, I suggest you to get the wall mount adapter to put it as high as possible in order to not obstruct communication.
Here's the robot, we're gonna mount the base right here. So I'm gonna fast forward the boring physical stuff and I'll see you soon. All right, we are back. I finished installing the cable and setting up the base. As you can see, it's pretty simple. We have only one wire here that connects to the base, and the base connects to an electrical outlet. In the package, you're gonna have also another pair of cable if you don't want to install the RTK antenna on the base, for example, if you want to put it on the wall. But as I set the RTK antenna directly on the base, I only needed this cable that was with this antenna and directly plugged it into the base. This is a cool first playground for the robot, as we have some obstacles. We have the pool perimeter that he has to go around. We have a few trees, so we're gonna see how it performs.
Now let's use the Mowing app to go on the setup process. The Luba 2 works over Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and or 4G. You use Bluetooth to manually control the robot and create mowing zones. And for remote control, the robot needs to connect to Mowing's cloud either via Wi-Fi or 4G. If you don't have Wi-Fi coverage, 4G is a very nice alternative if you can get a double SIM card from a carrier. An important detail is that you don't need to have a full Wi-Fi coverage for the robot. You can give him instructions when it's connected to the Wi-Fi signal next to its charging station, and the robot will go and work autonomously, even without being connected to Wi-Fi. You just won't receive real-time notifications if anything happened. The pairing process was easy but a bit confusing since I had the possibility to pair both the RTK antenna and the robot, but it wasn't explained if it was mandatory and why would I need to do that. So at first, I thought it was because we had the possibility to connect multiple antennas to the robot in order to extend its range, which would have been a fire feature. But apparently it's not the case, so let's move on. Connectivity wise, I decided to test both the SIM card and the Wi-Fi approach. Not gonna lie, it didn't work on my SIM card at first. So I had to connect the robot to my phone's hotspot. After downloading a few mandatory updates, my SIM card was finally detected and had a working 4G coverage. Another thing I noticed is that the robot keeps on disconnecting from the app. You have to press the reconnect button often 2 or 3 times in a row for the app to get a stable connection with the robot. All of that even if the robot had an excellent network connection. Moving on, I started creating the main mowing zone for the robot. This was very fun as you need to move your robot like an RC car around your defined perimeter. I just love the look of this robot, it looks like a Formula 1 car. Honestly, I think I won't resist the urge to buy some stickers pretty soon. On the app, you can create mowing zones, no-go zones, and paths between the zone you defined. I then proceeded to create the main no-go zone, which was the pool deck. Be very careful not to move the station or the antenna as they are very sensitive. If you move them, even slightly, it can shift all of your zones. I had to go and recreate my zones as I accidentally bumped into the base with the robot while controlling it manually. I think this is something that could be fixed via a software update, as a lot of smart vacuums are quite forgiving regarding their base station. In fact, they tend to update the map each time the robot runs. Everything is now finally set up, let's fire up that robot. You can customize a bunch of things for each task, like the cutting height for example. It can go as low as 25 millimeters or as high as 70 millimeters. You can modify the task speed and of course the cutting mode path, the most time consuming being the chessboard path. There are other settings that are quite confusing as the app is badly translated and doesn't explain what it's supposed to do. You have four obstacle detection modes that go from direct touch to avoiding touch at all. I like the slow touch mode to avoid false positives. At the bottom of the screen, you get a nice preview of the job and an approximate duration, although that doesn't include the charging times when the robot will be low on battery. Apart from the chessboard path, I left everything as default and started the robot.
Start working.
The first thing I noticed is how quiet the robot is while mowing. It's barely noticeable when you're not close to it. It is rated to be 60 decibels loud, it's so quiet, it's a real pleasure. If you're a bit far, you wouldn't even think that something is working, that the robot is even mowing something. But it is actually. The mowing itself is perfect. The grass is cut flawlessly, even on thick grass. I really like the zero turn technology and the omni wheels, allowing the robot to not be stuck in any situation. The Luba 2 is said to be pretty good on steep slopes and rough terrains, and I can't wait to test it out outside the pole. Regarding obstacle detection, it's not perfect but it's good enough. The 4 mode obstacle detection setting is a nice feature that will satisfy any type of terrain. I'm sure it will get even better with software updates over time. I had an issue regarding perimeters, both of the mowing zone and the no-go zone. The robot was going too far from the border. After digging on Reddit, I found it was related to the perimeter and no-go zone mowing laps. Again, I think my motion could benefit from a real translation here. I first tried the maximum setting that got the robot definitely too close, and I finally settled for this setting as that was what worked best for me. Obviously, don't expect the grass to be cut on the edges, as it's physically impossible for the robot to do so. Regarding the battery, I feel like the Luba 2 could benefit from a bigger battery pack, as it needs to be back on the base after mowing 250 square meters on a flat terrain with default setting and the chessboard path. I think it's really low, considering the robot is given for 5000 square meters, meaning that the robot would need to charge approximately 20 times in order to mow 5000 square meters in optimal conditions. In my case, and for this specific terrain, I'm not particularly bothered by that, especially because the robot isn't noisy at all. But the app could definitely benefit from a more accurate time estimation, taking the charging times into account, just like planning a trip on a Tesla. The robot is also equipped with a rain detector, which allows him to automatically go back to its base when it's raining. And to further protect him from rain, I encourage you to get the Luba's garage that can easily be attached on top of the base. Regarding the anti-theft feature, there is apparently a siren system that fires off once the robot is out of the mowing zone. I didn't test it, but I think that such system can't completely prevent a thief from taking your robot. In which case, what you could do is place your AirTag or equivalent somewhere hidden in the robot. Or use a 4G SIM card as it will allow the robot to report its location while it still has battery. Talking about SIM card, I wanted to give a try to the Wi-Fi only coverage. So, I went to the supermarket and bought a power line adapter to get Wi-Fi coverage next to the robot's base. And it works flawlessly. I can even watch the robot mowing with its camera, even when the robot is quite far from the Wi-Fi signal. Regarding smart home integrations, I didn't find any on the Alexa app or the Google Home app. According to my motion, those integrations are going to be released soon. But if you follow me, you know I'm mostly interested in open integrations, especially with Home Assistant. Unfortunately, my motion didn't release any official integration or API yet. I hope they will. But as per usual, the amazing smart home community found a way to communicate with the Luba and release an unofficial integration that is still under development. It uses a Bluetooth proxy to do very basic things like start and stop the mower, check its status, battery level, and so on. I'm looking forward to seeing more on that, but please, Mamotion, an official integration would be fantastic and I'm sure it would satisfy the smart home community. Overall, I'm very happy with the Luba 2. I think it has great potential. The main pain point of the whole product is the app itself that would need to be fixed and translated properly with educational material to onboard new users. But those are things that can be easily fixed with a software update. About the mowing itself, I have nothing to say. It's simply flawless. The robot is discreet with around 60 decibels of noise and backed up by a good obstacle detection that I'm sure will be perfected over time. The positioning of the robot is extremely accurate and it never got stuck. When it runs low on battery, the Luba 2 has no issue coming back home and automatically go back to it when charged. This is a very robust robot that can take up on any challenge, and I'm looking forward to placing the RTK antenna on the roof and make the Luba take care of a way bigger terrain. This will be certainly the topic of the next video.
And I think that covers it up. I spent 2 full days trying this robot, even though it has pros and cons, obviously, like any product. The study is setting behind me, so drop a comment if you have any question, and I'll see you soon. Bye.